the middle of a forest somewhere near Durham. Now, there aren't an awful lot of production vehicles that you could drive comfortably in a setting like this, but the Jeep is one of them. If you're an enthusiast of hardcore off-road vehicles, this is pretty much the last one standing. The Toyota Tacoma comes close. It's got a really impressive crawl feature, but the Jeep is pretty much unstoppable. This is the Willys Wheeler edition. It's a tribute package to the military vehicle of 75 years ago. It's built on a Wrangler Sport Limited platform. It has some exclusive appearance items like Willys stickers, rocker guards, and great big meaty tires. But the important thing is that this particular Jeep has a limited slip differential and 372 gears. If it were my money, I'd probably get a Wrangler Sport with a 6-speed. Now, these special tires are terrific for off-road, especially in the mud and gravel. However, they don't have the siping of true winter tires. On the highway, the Jeep is noisy. It tends to wander a little bit. It's not exactly aerodynamic. Plus, the rear seat is cramped. The interior is equally purposeful. It's designed to be rugged and to be washed clean easily. It's not exactly luxurious. Storage space is okay, but it's going to be a tight fit if you and three friends want to go camping with all your gear. Now, the list price on this vehicle is almost $36,000. For that, you don't even get backup camera, navigation, or heated seats. But what you do get is a vehicle that's virtually unstoppable off-road. The Jeep Wrangler is not designed for the 9-to-5 commute, unless your commute entails getting here. For Driving.ca, I'm Leslie Wimbush.